Unfortunately, this year there like is no stage group, so I don't have a microphone. So I'm going to talk even less than usual. So that's a good thing. I'm so excited that we were able to finally get the opportunity to do this concert tonight. It has been so long, and we have missed performing for you. So welcome to the concert, and we're going to get started with Colors at Home.
Thank you.
played before. I had a student who kept saying, why can't we play a song that's all pizzicato? So that's what we're doing. Plink, plank, plunk is played entirely pizzicato, so they will not be using their bows at all. So it's a totally different style from what you typically hear from us. Asked if they could play a song for you. So, in addition to this crazy COVID world that we live in, I can only have them up here for about less than 15 minutes at a time. So, most of them are going to leave the stage so that we can space them out for a little bit, and the seniors are going to stay and play Living on a Prayer. Thank you. only have three seniors. We have two violins and a cello. They needed a viola, so I'm in.
Thank you. Next, we have a group of students. There's a piece we've been working on for quite a bit this year, and it is definitely was a challenge piece that we had, and it is called The Sweeper Cells. And I cut it from the program because we were having a lot of problems with it. So some of the students came to me and asked if they got a small group together, if they could please do it. So they're going to do two movements from The Sweeper Cells. So if those students all want to come up, do I have everyone?
Yeah.
Okay. The suite has four movements to it, and each movement tells a little story. So the first movement is a lighthearted setting of a woman who lost her cat. So you have to picture somebody chasing around their cat. And then the next movement they're doing is the third movement, and it is the story of someone who is very sad because they lost someone very special to them. But they're sitting next to a fountain, and there's a nightingale that's singing just beautifully, and listening to the water is making them very happy. So those are the two movements we are going to do. need the rest of the students to come back up for our last two pieces. This year, because I didn't think we were really going to get the opportunity to do any concerts, I approached the year very differently than what I have other years. This year, I really tried to throw some harder music at them and some different styles and work on some different techniques and things. So then when we found out, I don't know, 3 weeks ago maybe, that we could do a concert, we were hurrying up to get some things kind of polished up for you. So the next song we'd like to play for you is from the Chronicles of Narnia. To me, this is an absolutely beautiful piece, and hopefully you've heard this maybe somewhere along the line. Students who volunteered their time to play with us I believe they both play jazz band and symphonic, right?
No.
Jazz band and wind ensemble, okay? And that is Rachel Skirka and Stephen Cobb. I'd like to thank them for their help. our last piece of the program is called Perpetuoso. If you had students involved in Strings North, I believe we played this in a couple years ago, and it was just a piece that I just absolutely loved at that time, and so I wanted to do it. So I kind of threw it at them early in the year, and most of them, I think, really enjoyed this piece. So thank you so much for coming to our concert finally after over a year. We were able to play for you. We have missed it, and so we're very glad to be able to have done this for you. I almost forgot one other thing I always do, and that's to recognize my seniors. Were there flowers somewhere? Where were they? Pardon me?
Come on, Jonathan.
So they got put somewhere and I didn't know where. That's funny. We're making a senior go get his own flowers. I love it. That's what we do. So while we're waiting, I'd like to talk to you a little bit about SASPA, the String Parents Association. It is a small group, but it is a group that works very hard for the students in front of you. This year we didn't end up wearing our gowns and tuxes because this was so much at the last minute that we didn't have passed out.
Right, this is for you.
Oh. Why, thank you. That's funny. These are the ones I want. So there is a piece in the program about SASPA. We are not permitted to hold a meeting in this building. Usually we do a face-to-face meeting, but instead we have to do a virtual meeting. I will let the students, we have a date, but I need to get the code out once we get that to you. And if as many of you as possible could join SASPA, it is a small group and we do different things. Typically at homecoming we have a booth. They also help tremendously on our trip. They help with the gowns and the tuxes of the students, and just in so many different small ways. When we do our big concert, they also provide pizza for the high school and the middle school, kind of a icebreaker to get the middle school students to get to know the high school students a little bit, since they will be joining us the following year. But there's so many things that SASPA does for us, so if you can please attend and join, because remember, there are more people helping out than everyone needs to do less work. So, thank you. All right. So, I'm just going to set these here for now.
We got another bouquet for you.
Wow.
Yeah, you're special.
Yeah, thank you. These are beautiful. Are these? I'll put them down here. These ones. How about that? We'll decorate the stage in our very small way. And for the seniors, it's been a tradition for years. I've always recognized my seniors at their final concert because it's kind of a bittersweet moment for them. I know they're really looking forward to moving on with their lives and with their new and exciting things that they're going to do, but it's also their last concert, something that they've been doing for so many years, you know, most of them since fourth grade. And so it's really become a huge part of their lives. So I always like to recognize my seniors. So we'll start with Spencer Angel. Kalei Yamali. And Jonathan Zhang. It's been my pleasure to work with these students all these years, and I will truly miss them. They've been some hardworking, dedicated students. We're very glad to have you back, Kalea. I know. I remember when you said you were going to move in elementary school, and I was like, no, you can't move. She's like, but my family's moving. I'm like, well, I guess you have to go with them. So, but she came back her senior year, so I was very excited by that. So these are our three seniors, and we wish them well. Thank you. I hope you have enjoyed our concert. I'll try and get us some lights so you can see where we're going.